see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
You hired Mike Cleary in the NCAA. What traits did you see in the young Mike Cleary, and what made you want to bring him into the NCAA fold?
Well, the NCAA was in the process of developing what was known as the college division, which were for some of the smaller institutions, and creating more opportunities for championships. And Mike came in as the supervisor of the overall championship events. He had a good reputation in Kansas City as running the professional basketball team. Also, he'd worked for the NAIA, where he gained a great experience in administering championships. Also, Mike had a great sense of humor and just was an enjoyable guy to be around. So he was a great addition.
I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Ooh, yeah.
Thank you. I'm going to shake this up a little bit. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to give everybody a chance to stand as you should for one purpose. This association was started 50 years ago by an individual who left the NCAA, and when he left the NCAA, Walter Byer said, "You'll never succeed with this." Mike Cleary not only succeeded, but Mike Cleary built something with great vision, and all of these ADs that are seated in front, and all of you that are out in the crowd have no idea that in the first convention, he had 30 exhibitors. That's what the program says. The fact is, he sold 12, and two of them didn't pay. So it's time for this whole place to stand and give a standing ovation to Mike Cleary.
I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway.
At the start, in 1965, at the NCAA convention, they didn't have a chance to socialize, they didn't have a chance to schedule. There was a lot of things that were missing.
LSU athletic director Jim Corbett was named their spokesperson, and he eventually would become NACTA's first president and namesake of NACTA's highest honor, the James J. Corbett Award.
He called the NCAA office when he came back, and he was looking for Walter Byers, who was our executive director. Well, those days we only had 11 people at the NCAA office. We had 6 males and 5 females. So he explains to me what they're trying to do, and he said, "We're looking for a sharp young guy who will come in here, get us off the ground, run a convention, put out a magazine."
I have been called the great one. I'm going to pass that on to someone who truly, to me, is the great one. Someone who started this and has worked tirelessly and is usually in the background. As you're going to be standing to leave, please stand and give a big round of applause to my friend Mike Cleary. Mike Cleary.
For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows.
I wish NACTA another great 50, and God bless you all.